Hi, this is Ezekiel O'Callaghan with Raptor Chatter, and today we're going to be looking at fluffy dinosaurs and the feathers of change. In 1861, scientists found what was widely held to be the missing link between birds and dinosaurs. Archaeopteryx had a long tail and teeth like a dinosaur, but wings like a bird. For over a century, it was the only dinosaur found with feathers, and the only species tangibly bridging the gap between dinosaurs and birds. That is until 1969, when John Ostrom described Deinonychus, and with the artwork from his graduate student Robert T. Backer, presented bird-like dinosaurs in an entirely new way. And so science and the public began to accept that dinosaurs had turned into birds, but that their separation was complete, distinctive, an institution. Dinosaurs were dinosaurs, and birds were birds. Nothing more, just sometimes they're similar. Then in 1996, Cynoceropteryx was found with feathers, then Cynarnithosaurus, and then a dozen other species. The line between bird and dinosaur was getting more and more blurred. It wasn't just the raptor dinosaurs, like Microraptor, that had feathers, but things like Velociraptor, Citipati, and Therizinosaurs. Then, in 2004, a new species named Dilong was shown to have feathers, and its studies showed it to be an early Tyrannosaur, meaning all other Tyrannosaurs to follow may have had feathers. Even Tyrannosaurus rex may have had feathers. And this upsets some people. To quote the blog from Discover magazine, Dead Things, "I am still emotionally scarred by a Pinterest post I saw of Tyrannosaurus sporting the plumage of a bald eagle." Pedantry aside, this sentiment was echoed elsewhere on the internet. Paleoblogger Mark Wildman said, "Do you really want the ultimate theropods, the megastars of the dinosaur world, the Tyrannosaurs, displaying colorful yet gaudy feathers and dancing like a demented turkey?" One of my own followers on Twitter even expressed some disdain at the idea of a fluffy T-Rex from my 2017 In Review video. The idea being presented is that feathers aren't scary enough, and dinosaurs should be scary. But birds can be perfectly scary. This is an African crowned eagle, which has attacked children as old as 5 years old and has eaten infants in the past. This is a cassowary, which has attacked and even killed a person before. And finally, this is footage of an eagle hunting a deer, because, you know, birds are terrifying. Feathers don't make something not scary. Change makes things scary. And just because T-Rex may be feathered doesn't mean it isn't scary. The perspective of most paleontologists has been, it isn't a matter of wanting it or not. It doesn't matter what people's opinion is, it matters what the science tells us. And right now, the science is telling us that Tyrannosaurus may have had feathers. The findings of Dilong show this. Feathers are part of the primitive condition of Tyrannosaurs. They were part of the original evolution and existence of Tyrannosaurs before the evolution of T-Rex. And like all primitive conditions, they have the potential to show up again. But T-Rex was massive, 40 feet long and weighing multiple tons, whereas Dilong and other early Tyrannosaurs were maybe a few feet long at most. And the feathers we found in Dilong were short, proto-feather dino fuzz. Not like long feathers that might work as an air brake on the arms or tail like we believe were used in things like Velociraptor. And so that means that these feathers were probably used for warmth, and something that's 40 feet long and multiple tons probably didn't have as much of a need for some covering like this to stay warm. And so it's important to remember that if T-Rex did have feathers, it probably wouldn't have looked like this, but much more like this. And so with no direct evidence for feathers, the idea of a fluffy T-Rex began to die down, at least until 2012 when Eutyrannus was found. Eutyrannus was a tyrannosaurid that was 30 feet long and covered thoroughly in feathers. So a large relative of T-Rex had feathers. In 2011, an ornithomimid dinosaur, so one of the ostrich mimics, was also found to have had a tail fan of feathers. And this was from a species that was 40 feet long, so as large as Tyrannosaurus. This means that large dinosaurs still had feathers, so perhaps even Tyrannosaurus rex had feathers. However, despite all this new information, the evidence against feathers has been mounting. Eutyrannus was found not to be as closely related to Tyrannosaurus rex as initially believed. In multiple Tyrannosaurs more closely related to Tyrannosaurus rex, skin impressions have shown a complete lack of feathers. In Albertosaurus, Gorgosaurus, and Tarbosaurus, skin impressions have been found from across the body and the tail, and none of these have had feathers. The largest hindrance to feathered T-Rex came in 2017, when a study looked at all the previously mentioned samples and a sample of Tyrannosaurus rex skin from its neck, again finding no evidence of feathers. Now, because the samples were patchy, the authors did conclude that it still may have had feathers, just not a full body covering of them. Due to the patchy record of large Tyrannosaurus having feathers, some scientists, like David Hone, have been fiercely advocating that yes, Tyrannosaurus rex probably had feathers, with other scientists taking a more modern approach. However, the recent documentary, The Real T-Rex, depicted Tyrannosaurus as having feathers. And while that idea might be wrong, just like the idea that T-Rex had to scavenge was wrong, if it can get someone interested in science or paleontology, then all is said that Fluffy T-Rex served humanity well. As for the backlash on a Fluffy T-Rex, I'm just worried for when people find out the Triceratops might have had feathers too. When the question is asked, which dinosaurs had feathers? Right now the best answer seems like it might be all of them. Maybe. And this isn't some, oh well, we can never really tell argument. Three finds have really redefined how paleontologists look at feathers in the fossil record. First, in 2009, Tianyulong, which was a heterodontosaurid, was found in China. This was followed in 2011 by another heterodontid discovery, this time Culindodromius. Now, both of these specimens had feathers, but were also very separated from the rest of the dinosaurs we knew at the time that had feathers. Despite living alongside things like Microraptor and Anchiornis, the species were separated by almost 80 million years of evolution. Previously, we had seen feathers on the Ceruloosaur branch of the dinosaur family tree, so things like the ostrich mimics, the raptors, and the tyrannosaurs. However, heterodontosauruses belong on the entire opposite side of the dinosaur family tree. Heterodontosaurs are among the earliest and most basal members of the Ornithischians, the branch of dinosaurs that would lead to species like Edmontosaurus, Triceratops, and Stegosaurus. Their placement as early Ornithischians puts feathers in a very hard-to-define place for what their origin was. For example, it could have been that the Ornithischians and the Ceruloosaurs both evolved feathers, but separately from each other. However, with them being early Ornithischians, it also means that it could have been a common ancestor trait of all dinosaurs to have feathers, meaning that potentially all dinosaurs could have feathers. Then, in 2016, Psittacosaurus was shown to have feathers, meaning feathers lasted into the Ornithischian line much longer than just the initial examples of Tianyulong and Culindodromius would have led on. Further evidence for all dinosaurs having feathers comes from the pterosaurs, which were evolutionarily very close to the first dinosaurs. In 1831, Scaphognathus was found to have had what seemed like small hair-like structures. Eventually, these were confirmed to exist in the species Sordis pilosus, translated as hairy demon. The specimen showed the first concrete evidence for what came to be known as pycnofibers. Now, with dinosaurs being so closely related to pterosaurs, it's possible that this trait for small hair-like structures, pycnofibers, or protofeathers came from their common ancestor, meaning feathers might even be older than mammals. And so this issue of which dinosaurs had feathers is still very much debated. Some families, such as the Ceruloosaurs, show a great affinity to feathers, while some species, like certain Hadrosaurs or Carnotaurus, have massive skin impressions preserved with them, all of which show no feathers. To help settle the debate, Paul Barrett and David Evans compiled a list of all known skin impressions from all known dinosaurs in 2013. From this study, they concluded that it's safer to say most dinosaurs didn't have feathers. However, they also mentioned a lack of good preserved skins from the early Jurassic or Triassic periods, when most of these dinosaur families were developing and beginning to branch out. A find from this time period, with or without feathers, would help to shed tremendous light on how feathers evolved and which species did or did not have them. But until that find happens, the best answer to the question, which dinosaurs had feathers, is maybe all of them did. With science as divided as it is, what are your thoughts on feathered T-Rex or feathered dinosaurs as a whole? Do you encourage the fluffball T-Rex idea? Or do you think that the way it looked in Jurassic Park is the way it should remain? Which dinosaur would be the most confusing to see with feathers? You can leave your comment below, or you can tweet me at raptor_chatter. Thanks for watching, everyone. This was a fun video to research, as there's just so much debate and public opinion surrounding this. Personally, I find it likely that a lot of the early dinosaurs did have feathers, but then they would have lost them depending on their environments. Please be respectful in the comments, and remember to be safe. Please try and save the planet. Don't go extinct. Take care.